Alright, have my goggles on and I'm ready to play. My name is Sloth154 and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Last episode we went to... where the hell were we? Essex. It was an event. It wasn't really too, eventful.
Eivor. Out the gate.
So this episode we're going to, Lincolnshire. Yeah, Lincoln. I don't want to break up with her, but I can't. I have to ignore those. Down. No.
I want to see the Alliance map.
Yeah, so we're going to Lincolnshire because it'll give me raw materials, which I need. Actually. Yeah, it gives me raw materials, which I need. And it'll have
what
the last...
Lincolnshire? A rather boisterous man named Hunwald arrived recently, wishing to speak with you. On a matter of great importance, he said.
Where is he now?
Down at the docks, carousing with my scouts and scaring the fish from the river. He waits for you with great eagerness.
Okay. Yeah, all that happened in Essex was we helped the guy get back with his childhood girlfriend.
He sounds charming. I will meet him at once.
Because back then, marriage and relationships were political ammo. Yeah, ammo. I'm gonna stick with that. Huh. I didn't notice I started hanging my kills. So that's the blood boar. There's the wolf I killed. Another wolf I killed. There's the wolf I killed. There's the bear. There's two more I have to hunt down. Three more I have to hunt down. Alright, let's go to the dock and talk to this guy. Because doing Lincolnshire will get me the last person in the liar in one of the magistrates' chain of command, which is the, what is he called? No, ignore that. Yeah, we're going after the Crozier? We're going after this guy. He's going to be in Lincolnshire, and he's the last one I need to hunt down to, get all the clues I need on the liar. So if I do this well enough, we'll just go right into killing the magistrate. Hopefully it won't take another full episode.
This is true happiness, isn't it, men? Life in the rough.
Rollo, returned from Francia already. This is a surprise.
Oh, he's back.
Is the Lady Estrid well?
She is. Had a rough few weeks upon our return, but she is on her feet and with her family. And I am looking for a new adventure. If I remember right, you said I might...
No.
You may think this
all right, odd, we're back.
But our lively chatter here has inspired in me a short poem. May I recite it for you?
Go on, Lord the Boy. Make me tremble.
Oh, indeed, I shall try. I call it Ode to a Hungry Flame.
Another skull come to join us?
Me? Oh, goodness, no. I'm no scald, no. Just a humble nobleman with an interesting
versification. Is this the guy I'm
gonna
have to kill?
An amateur, really. Shall I continue?
I'm not here to judge your poems, Lord. Speak your purpose or down your meat.
Yes. Sorry. I have come with the hope of meeting Eivor, the great warrior of this clan. If such an audience is possible.
Every warrior in this clan deserves a song or saga, Lord. Why Eivor?
Because her name alone dries the tongues of my enemies. If such a hero fought beside me, I'd fear nothing.
What is your name, Lord?
I am Hundwald, loyal son of Lord Hunbeor, the current Elderman of Lincolnshire. May God keep and cure him. You see, my father is ailing, and in his delirium, evil men have corrupted his judgment. A secret and powerful order, if the whispers are true. Only a month ago, without forewarning, Mercian soldiers chased me, his only son, from my home.
Really?
I know not why, but I do know my father would never have ordered my exile.
Outcast from your family. That is a hard road to walk.
Could one of your clan help me return to Lincoln? March beside me through the city gates and set me at my father's noble feet once again.
Huh, what's your shirt? Yeah.
It may be we can help you, but we'll want something in return. An alliance between our clan and yours.
And you shall have it. My father is a great friend of the Danes, in spite of the recent wars.
You sing a sad song, Hunwald of Lincolnshire. A son robbed of his father's protection. Now desperate to prove his honor. How far will you go to regain it? To a bloody end?
Oh, indeed. I will plunge into the heat of battle to defend my father, knowing our cause is a righteous one.
All right, young lord. My clan has need of me just now, but when I'm ready, we'll find your father together and right the wrongs you've suffered.
Ah, you are the chieftain here. I suspected as much. God praise you, Eivor.
Not the chief.
I won't be leading you into the heart of a shield wall, but there will be danger. I want your word. You will follow my orders to the rune.
I am yours to abuse.
If it comes to that.
I'll wait for you in my safe haven, Bottleston to the northeast. From there, we shall make our way to Lincoln.
Goodbye, Lord Boy. Safe travels.
God bless and keep you all.
I fear I may be escorting that boy to his own execution.
That These things might happen. Shut him up.
Yeah, after the technical difficulties, we're on our way to Lincolnshire. So where are we going? As you can see, I was doing a lot in between the episode. I just couldn't stop myself. Alright, I'm gonna make my way to Lincolnshire. So I'll see you guys once I get there. There he is.
So this is Hunwald's safe haven.
Though we be a Mercian Shire today, tomorrow the kingdom of Lindsay will rise again. As free as the wind on the back of my neck.
Your line of kings died long ago, Hunwald. We're in Lincolnshire.
Hunwald, stop talking shit and get in gear.
Hunwald, who is this stranger?
Eivor, come, sit. Bread and ale, please, alewife. I have been discussing my delicate situation with Alvgar here.
Lord.
He is a nobleman like me. One of Lincolnshire's sturdy thanes.
Really?
Hunwald's idea of sturdy is a mug of ale that won't tip over.
Alvgar has pledged his loyalty to my family, the House of the Ferocious Swan. With his influence,
well,
and
swans
your
are
might,
assholes,
we shall
but not
rid
ferocious.
Lincolnshire of the ruffians who plague this land, once and for all.
We're going to see your father, Hunwald. That's all.
Indeed, Eivor. With speed and purpose, you are the axle to my wheel, the spark to my tinder.
I can only bring you as far as your father, Hunwald. You are the man who must reach his heart and lead him to reason.
Are we talking about the same man? Your father is a spendthrift, Hunwald. He ran this shire into the muck.
Oh, Alvgar, you jest.
Listen, I've come to escort you to your father's side. We go now, or I walk.
Ah, yes, to Lincoln! Away! But with care. The road between here and there is teeming with...
Why are you focusing on this guy?
Dead.
You daft lump of lard. A single Dane will not protect you against the whole of Mercia's army.
I think you're wrong, Alvgar. And here she'll prove it.
What?
I'm hot for a fight, Snowdog. Give me half a chance. I'll stove your heathen face right in.
Do not fuck
with
me.
Have you ever seen a blood eagle, my Saxon friends?
A what?
A blood eagle. A raw, magnificent bird I'll tear from your guts. First I crush your ribs. Then I pull out your lungs and stretch them into wings so you can fly to your heaven as fast as possible.
Jesus fucking Eden.
You canny fox.
Watch your mouth.
That was incredible. Like watching a captain navigate the roiling waters of an angry river. I must void my bladder, Eivor. Then we shall set forth in search of adventures new.
You travel with a marked man at your side.
He's with me. You'll be fine.
If I had a scribe jot down all the occasions I'd warn that stupid boy, I'd be the most written about man in history.
Alvgar, the boorish nag of Lincolnshire.
It's only been a couple seconds. You went pee.
Oh, I told Hunwald to stay near. God, my eyes. Hunwald's in trouble.
They call this.
Leave him be!
Jesus! He's brought a bloody Dane!
They say the Silver Age paying us.
Struck down, pruned within an inch of my life. But I will survive. I must. Continue as you would, Eivor. And if I should expire,
Hunwald, get up. You.
I live.
Fucking drama queen.
I am alive. Heaven have mercy.
Are you hurt?
Unbelievable. The Battle of Bottlestone will be remembered for years to come. Alfgar, we have won our first great victory.
Hunwald, are you hurt?
Never better, I...
We should get to Lincoln as quickly as we can.
Yes, yes, you're right. Let's depart.
That boy's gonna die.
What horrible souls are hunting me? Me, the son of a beloved elderman. Was it naive of me to believe my status as a nobleman held some sway over the chaerls and serfs of this shire?
Yes.
What cause have any to dishonor me? Look! Boats there! We could sail the waters to Lincoln, sink the ships of any enemies in our way.
What were you told when the guards exiled you?
I'm not
you?
Going on the water
oh,
with him.
Scraps of nonsense. I woke to screaming. A man grabbed me, said I was an immediate danger to my father. Ha! Horse pucky! Mercian soldiers then shackled me, rode me blindfolded to the River Wash, and told me plainly, start anew elsewhere, or face death in Lincolnshire.
What did they mean?
Oh, some nonsense about me praying for his... death. Hungry for his inheritance.
Speak plainly, Hunwald. I cannot help you if I don't know the full story. You hold no grudge against your father?
No, never. No, I suspect the order for my exile came from on high. Perhaps one of Burgred's final order. Here's Lincoln, the city of my birth, the cauldron of my present sorrows.
Mercy and gods everywhere. Follow me.
What the fuck is
Shadow Walker? My heart beats like the drums of your dragon boat.
Act cool, kid. I don't want to have to kill everyone here because you got excited.
This town is your home?
It was.
And should still be.
Oh, to see it now fills my eyes with tears.
Save weeping for prayers. We're not inside yet.
One day I won't have to skulk around this town with my face hidden. I will walk proudly among the people I love.
How was your father the last time you saw him?
He was quite poorly, but he has the heart of a lion and the Holy Spirit itself within him. A bout of ill.
What do you see?
Ah, good. I can continue. He was quite poorly, but he has the heart of a lion and the Holy Spirit itself within him. A bout of ill.
Yeah, I don't really care about what your dad going through. I have to sneak you into this place that's teeming with guards. And it has a proper fucking roof. Keep up, boy.
Hunwald! Praise God, you live! I do, my dear Reaganhair, body and soul. Tell my father his son has returned and in fighting form. It is urgent I speak with him.
I swear to God.
Sorry, Lord, but your father has been taken.
Taken? When?
Weeks ago, Lord. And well ill he was when they carried him off. I wish I could say more.
Who took the Elderman? Was it soldiers or men of God?
There were men with swords. And those of the cloth. And a healer, too. One who had oft been a guest in this house.
Galwina, one of the sisters my father put great faith in. He still has friends in Lincoln. That's a good sign.
Unless Bishop Hereford among them. He's kept a vigil at the town hall, looking after things in your father's absence until he returns.
Will we find trouble there, at the town hall?
You mean soldiers and the like? Aye, there have been many, many more about since your father took his leave.
Right, we'll find a quiet way in if we can.
I really hope I can find a quiet way in. First, I saw a letter. My lord stumbled again, took to bed in the early noon, keeping to his tomes and scrolls, made some commentaries on the former kings of Lindsay, was cheery in spite of the full season of feeling unwell. Lord feels poorly today. Some food went down and then came up. I supplied him with water and mead. Same result. Hunwald arrived in the evening and stayed by his father's side, talking loudly of a Dane lady he has befriended in the north. Another day of weeping and prayers. Lord says he feels as if he has swallowed a live hedgehog and a cricket, and now the former Dane designs to change the latter out of his inside. Hunwald not seen for many weeks. His father seems to not notice his absence. Soldiers arrived at the behest of Abbess Atcha. Okay. and bade my lord follow, which he did without complaint. I continue the daily chores, not knowing if or when I shall see my lord again, yet with so much time freed up, I dare note here that my Latin has improved with practice. To one day read the scriptures of myself in the Holy Roman tongue would be a blessing indeed. I pray for my lord's safe return, but not so soon. I just have to wait for Henry VIII. Anything worth stealing here?
Who was that fellow?
Reaganhair? He's an old fixture of my family's household. Loyal to the end. He helps run the place. And he's known me since I was but a little lordling.
I'm not reading his poetry.
A simple fellow, but worth every pinch of his salt.
Bugger all. Again.
Sunan, guide me.
What the hell? How did he do that and I can't? Shut up. We missed smokes? Okay, we did. Keep up, Hunwolf. Let me get in the middle here.
Move along.
Was this the urge?
Keep going.
Even seems a good place to trade.
Does it?
The market is flush with goods.
Yes, it must be. Growing up, we never wanted for anything in my father's home. Bread and poultry and field fruits of all manner. I suppose this is where our servants purchased them. Lincoln's boon was ours as well.
How often did you leave your house, Humboldt?
Oh, from time to time. Yes.
Unfortunately, the hair told Finland.
Beachness, safe, belonging, really.
Is he fake whistling?
I need your eyes, my friend.
Alright, I did it without... Well, I only killed one person. I did that like an assassin.
Archer, Herevrith! Tell Lord Hunbeor his son has returned!
My lord, you're well.
Lord Hunwar.
Also, his father's being poisoned. No, that's kind of obvious. And that's the guy who I had to kill.
You might have sent a messenger and spared us the suspense.
Why so surprised to see my return, Bishop? Was I rumored dead?
Oh, worse than dead. It is my reluctant duty to report the rumor that you were lost in the north, bedding a Dane on some squalid farm.
Hunwald came to me for aid, and I agreed to help. Whatever rumors you've heard have nothing to do with me.
Seriously.
I am
it's not my type.
Worried that Lord Hunbeor's wayward son is in danger of besmirching his reputation beyond repair. That is all.
I have no patience for insults and rumor. We've come to speak with Lord Hunbeor. That's all.
Lord Hunbeor has gone, I'm afraid. He would not say where to, but I'm sure he will return shortly. Once the storm has passed.
What on earth do you mean by that? What storm?
Your father feared for his life, Hunwald. In his weakened state, he could not defend himself. Not against a Dane, certainly.
How dare you? Eivor is above reproach.
See this from my view, Hunwald. You arrive after a strange absence, with a hired Viking in tow, demanding to see your father. This does not, in my estimation, imply benign intentions.
Hunwald's seen the point of a dagger more than once this week. I'm only here to protect him.
Your father was at my hospice for some days, and very well treated. But he left in secret. That's all we know.
That's because I know you're poisoning him, bitch.
That's odd. He's not one to scurry about in the dark.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. We have searched high and low for him, but to no avail. Come, Abbess. We should leave this young lord to his scurrying thoughts. There is nothing more of use we can say to him.
Take care, my boy.
Stay within these walls where you're safest. I will have a look around, see what I can learn about your father.
If my father spent time at the hospice here, the healers who work there may know something. Talk to them if you can. Find out what they know.
I'll find out what they know. Anything worth stealing, though? Well, fuck you too. Ah, oh, brothers! Let's go. These monks are my best friends.
Move along.
Will do. These monks are the most helpful people in this game. Thanks, guys.
His father was recuperating here not long ago. Someone may have seen him depart.
Pump it away! Again, anything worth stealing here? Wait, why that? How's it going, sister? I have questions. A couple of suggestions.
Are you the head sister here? Aye. And I'm not too comforted by the sight of you wielding weapons like a war chief. We're a hospice, not a barracks. It's bad enough I've got these armored cod pieces watching me work. Now you!
No harm will come to you or those you care for. I'm only looking for your eldermen.
I'd be risking my neck telling you anything. And if my head rolls, these sick and ailing folk will follow me to the grave.
Your eldermen would agree. So the sooner I find him, the more quickly these prowling guards will leave your hospice.
That's a pleasant thought. Our lord was in a bad way here, and getting worse, in spite of our efforts. Then, quite against my instruction, some guards moved him out. I overheard them talking about a bathhouse. There's no working bathhouse in Lincoln. So, I gather they meant the old ruins just south of here, by the eastern walls.
Ruins just south of here. I will look there, thank you.
I pray you find him. He's in desperate need of care.
Alright, so the alderman is in the ruins to the south.
Be my eyes soon.
That's really close by. In the mood for this. Meditate real quick. I miss. Hopefully I don't have to kill everyone.
It weren't wise to let those Mercians nobles use our tunnels, if you ask me. What choice do we have? At least this way they'll leave us be.
They killed one of their own. What's to stop them from splitting our skulls as well?
Because they fear us, see? No one takes us for fools, you got it.
Remember, God punishes those who wish ill upon...
Go on. Ill upon who?
Eh? Oh, sorry, I was miles away, what?
Christ Jesus, you haven't got enough brains in your head to blink, have you?
Thank you.
Ah, so that's how they get in the city. Oh, I didn't miss. Steal from these guys. Now we'll go into the tunnel.
These tunnels run deep. Was the Elderman fleeing to a hideaway beneath Lincoln?
This seems like it's gonna be a big fight. If I had a nickel for every time I had to go through sewers.
I should not be seen in this area.
Oh, there's a lot of them. Huh. I'm taking them out quickly. There we go. Cleared out the sewer. Right. One more scan. Yeah, this place is clean. Roaring Meg's Spring. Here? No, this is different.
There was fighting here. About what?
Or who? Wow, that's a lot of blood.
A violent struggle between nobles and bandits. The bandits did not fare so well. A noble's cloak with the image of a swan. Looks like the Elderman passed this way.
There's the key.
A key. Useful if I had a door to match it.
Oh, that's cheap. Oh, look, a door. Guess what we needed. Orvin, we have received an offer from an unnamed Saxon requesting safe passage through the sewer to Boiling Brook. The amount is considerable, which leads me to believe they have something of great value they cannot afford to be seen with. Insist on seeing what it is before accepting their offer. If it merits, it's double the amount. If they refuse, kill them. Lucian.
A Saxon nobleman paid some bandits for permission to sneak through these tunnels on their way to Bolingbroke Castle. Mercian nobles made a deal with some bandits. Paid them hush money to let them sneak through these caves. When the time came, the bandits ambushed the nobles. But it did not end well for the bandits. In the struggle, the Elderman's cloak was torn off. But he got away and headed east for Bolingbroke Castle. That's my best lead.
All right, are we about to get ambushed? No. All right, we're on our way to Bowling Rock Castle. How far is it? 600 meters? Yeah, that's doable.
Fresh air.
Huh. I didn't know the rest of the bridge was down. Oh god, snake! Run, horse!
Best not to draw attention here.
Well, that's hard with who we are. Now time to play snipe those heads. Of course he's in the main castle. I got the key. This is not ideal.
Why can we not enter the keep now? Is it all gold and silver up there?
Pipe down, lad. Keep your nose out of that business. It's not a topic you need knowing about.
Huh?
I just gotta take out three more. I gotta wait for this guy to move before I can kill him. Cause those two are watching him. I don't know who's the tactical genius who thought of this design, but yeah. The only way I could get into the next area is to shoot down the drawbridge. First, I gotta set these guys on fire. Long way around. Took the tower. Now I could take out these guys. Ah, oh, shit, they have the buddy system down. Scared the living shit out of me. Kill that guy.
I'm on the right track. That keep is well protected.
Ah. Sorry you had to die in your sleep. Amos. I've killed too many people. Focus of the Nornir. Oh, this. Nah. How's it going?
There now, my lord. All is prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Alderman?
He's dead.
This biscuit has been dry for some time, sister. How long has the Alderman been dead?
Dead is such a drastic word. I like to think of my lord as transformed.
He's dead.
That's not untrue.
Have you need of anything?
Hunwald deserves to know the truth about his father's fate. He's owed an inheritance and deserves a chance to become Elderman himself.
All in good time, I imagine.
No, now.
When the guards put him in my care, I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I should have killed more of them.
I have seen all I need to, but Hunwald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects, though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve.
That brush is just floating in the air.
I'll find something. Dried herbs and berries, crushed into powder.
The time between my lord's departure and his burial is longer than usual. My lord must keep up appearances for his upcoming rites.
Gwalnan's journey. Left him here, they did, weak and frail, carried him by his arms, feet dragging behind, dropped him on the floor with a thud, No way to treat an elderman. Not right, not right. But no better place for him, no. Lord Hunnelbart has found his way into my company. My tenderness I will share is what he deserves.
A box of musty clothing and a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do. I'll return this brooch to Hunwald in Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news.
Take care.
And you. I shall take you to your family crypt at Nettleham within Lincoln. There, you may lay beside your forebears, the great and glorious kings of old Lindsay. Please, do not desecrate our lord.
I am Dane, not a cruel griefmonger. Foul rat droppings everywhere.
Even in death, my lord is a friend to all of God's creatures.
She is scary.
I do not know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes, I thought the same. Troubling.
Are those pea buckets? Regnal tribute eliminated text. The genealogy of the Anglian kings of Lindsay. Our kings who under God and Warden's rule shall be remembered. Their line is endless as the great sky as they ruled the land of the Lindsizzies? I don't know. For the Britons and the Anglians alike, we kneel to them. Wooden, Krita, Krulgil, Kelbet, Wubba, Beda, Biskop, Infroth, Ita, Alfred, Ungarth, Humbroth, and Hunwald. The final name is scratched out with the monk's throne. You know I gotta do this. Be damned. Alright, so I'm gonna make my way back to Lincoln and tell the kid what happened to his father. So I'll see you guys when I get there. By the way, guys, I gotta give someone bad news. I don't know how much I had to cut out of that last sequence because I decided to do it quietly, but I did a lot. There was a lot I had to do. Well, sneak past. Hey, buddy, I got some bad news.
Eivor, what news?
Your father is dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Hunbjörg's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone.
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer. Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son. Do not forget it.
Keep steady, Hunwald. You are now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain. Last in a line of dwindling nobles.
That's because you guys haven't been getting freaky enough.
Here,
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
You're a fucking snake, and I'm gonna be glad when I...
You need a new Elderman here, and it falls to King Cheovulf to make that choice.
But once we find agreement, Eivor, the nobles here will convene a Shire Moot to select a new candidate. The winner will stand before the king for approval.
Explain how this works, your Shire Moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our Shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot. But between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
Someone in the Shire wants Hunwald dead. If I have to assemble an army to make sure this meeting is not an ambush, I will.
The Shire Moot is a lawful, godly assembly. Hunwald will be safe, as will you be.
Well, most men to cloth back then were assholes.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Elderman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this Shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and will convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
He's gonna be dead.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ, or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my god commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
Oh, you can count on it.
With Hunbeorth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archa went to console him. I should follow her.
What the? I'm gonna talk to Hunwolf first. Ah, brothers. Thank you for showing up. I needed your help. Yeah, fuck, I'm going over the wall. Don't get me wrong, I love the monks, but they're just slow.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title.
He's fragile and scattered.
I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
What devil put you up to all this deception?
I wasn't put up, Eivor. I felt compelled to carry on for the good of the Shire. Until I knew the truth.
A pretty answer for an ugly lie.
Yeah, lady.
What's going on?
Nothing. Just ignore me. Huh, they ignored me. Let's go check on the boy.
I remember the days.
Hello?
Hunwald and Swanborough.
Is that you?
Yeah, yes.
Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald?
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate. Contemplate the view.
Be easy with your grief, Hunwald. If you're not careful, it's a poison you'll bear in your blood for the rest of your life.
No need to worry. For I have found the antidote for it.
That won't work.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness. But let your aching love light the mead of your eyes, and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time.
I want to be cruel to him, but I'm not going to.
And I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To your father, Lord Hunbeorth of Lincolnshire. He may have dwindled from this world in death, but in life he was as stalwart as this tree.
A wife's old oak. Yes.
Skull.
And then my father says, it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humor, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right. Your Dane lady love, she sounds lovely.
We get drunk way too much.
To be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Oh, the horse knows what it's doing.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my Shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You have never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound. Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter. Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendor-full, why come to England at all?
You cannot grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, Your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so, quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect it. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced.
And ruinous.
But I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be a poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course. But give me that chance. My God, I just want to have that chance.
Did I lose him? Sorry, I was reading something.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor. Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Nope, it's an ambush.
Quiet. Stop here. Something isn't right. I'll find the trouble before it finds us.
Eivor, I am sweating from pit to...
Sunan, guide me. Hush. Stay calm. Hide or fight, Hunwald! Now!
Did he run ahead?
Twice they tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck, but if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead, and they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I am serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Elderman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy. To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
Well, if he had any brains, he would get on his horse. This is gonna take a while, so I'll see you guys when we get there.
Oh, thank the heavens! There she is!
Please tell me it's the girl standing in front of the statue.
Dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilted without you, but still I grow.
And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here out of sight until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. This shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the shire as he did.
Whatever strength you lack,
listen to your woman.
Swanborough, heed her advice.
Yes. If anyone can lift my spirits in time for the Shire moot, it's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I do not doubt it.
All right. So he's safe. Now we gotta go to... God damn it, it's gonna be far, isn't it? We gotta get to here. So I'll see you guys as soon as I meet with Afgar. But yeah, that's gonna take a bit. So see you soon. All right, guys, here we are. Hopefully nothing bad happens.
Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Alfgar, it's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
If this belonged to the Elderman, shouldn't it go to Hunwald next?
Yeah.
I suppose so. But I thought you a more fitting recipient. You'd know how to use it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moats. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
Please don't let him be...
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has been badgering my estate for weeks. I must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear.
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is old and ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. But today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your Your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Thor?
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you. What little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herodriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damned decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified.
Are we hunting, Elgar? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely!
What the hell is that?
The bear's lair should be nearby.
Oh, another bear. Wait, is that a warhawk?
Ah, my old friend Grimm. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt, as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right, very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
As I was saying, that is really offensive.
It is good to meet you, Grimm.
Hey, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just
up
the
hill there.
He's
a fucking politician.
Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Elfgar claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we?
All right, let's go.
There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
Yeah, God's independent. He doesn't really care about what you think. Why the fuck would you run in front of me?
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that.
Uh-oh.
That's not good. Wolves.
Well,
oh God. Hey, Lord. There's something you'll want to see.
Is that smoke? My God! My estate is burning like a twig!
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but please! By God, help me with this!
I'm in this fight.
Yeah,
with
let's
you.
Do this.
A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me.
Don't die.
My people are fleeing. They must get to safety.
Someone waited until you were away to set your world aflame.
Where is Alvgar, bloody Dane lover?
Follow my lead.
Where?
With me, brother.
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
How? Okay. I don't have to play firefighter.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Alvgar. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toil. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shiremood will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
Alright, so I'm gonna get back to Lincoln and talk to Acha. Or Achu. Oh, it's just a bear, you big babies. So I'll see you guys when I get there. Alright, we're back in Lincoln. Time to talk to Acha. There we go.
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shiremood will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yeah, let's do this.
I'm curious to see this Shiremood for myself. I will follow.
When will the vote begin, Abbess?
12 able lords of Lincolnshire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
What the fuck?
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald, as I love my own kin. But I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
All right.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before I vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man, if somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
King Cheowulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
I
He's
see.
Learning fast. Good man.
I am sorry about his son.
Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Alfgar is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is. And a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about.
So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
Huh. Good evening, Elvgar.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It is a difficult choice, Elvgar. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good, good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnshire into progress and victory.
I do not doubt your convictions, Lord.
A vote for Hunwald will return the House of the Ferocious Swan to its former glory.
How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There is more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That is good to hear. Bishop.
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear you vouched for me, Bishop.
I surprised myself, to be honest. But I felt it would be a good test of God's faith in my judgment. Under my guidance, this Shire is crawling back from a decade of lawlessness. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnshire. I pray now that he guides your hand accordingly.
All right, Hereforth is not getting my vote.
Well then, I thank you for what it's worth. God go with you.
He's 100% a member of the Order of the Ancients, so he's not getting my vote. It's between Kid and the politician.
Free men, free possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It is not for myself I must cast the stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All free have strengths and weaknesses.
It's between these two. Now, I'm gonna flip a coin. 1 second. I'm actually gonna go find a guy.
Alright.
Okay. I found the dime. Head for Elfgar, tail for Hunwald. Hunwald. That's 2 out of 3. First one, tails. Center and Hunwald. Second one, heads. Oh, come down to the last one. Come down to the last one. What will it be? Huh. Neat.
Though tinged with arrogance, Elvgard is competent and wealthy. He'd be a good elderman, but a faithful ally. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need.
Going by the coin. The coin has decided.
Lead your Shire with pride, ferocious swan.
Yeah, that bishop was not getting my vote. He's
it is decreed
the guy
by
from the order.
Lawful Shire moot that the Elderman of Lincolnshire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hunbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnshire.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what to say. I thank you. Deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best. For each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Eldermen. As all well know, this Shiremute's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Ceolwulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Ceolwulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results.
Did he just do?
Our good and noble friend, Arvelswith.
A septic rot has overtaken this shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Yeah, your that's grace. Why I didn't vote for you.
What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnshire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Steal yourself.
Yeah, that is 100% him. Picked the wrong master. My fault.
Christ is surely with us.
To hell with you.
Is this how their god welcomes the new Elderman?
You guys haven't got to see me do that yet. Yeah, I have a harpoon.
Bastard bishop. What's his endgame?
This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Elderman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you waste no time in catching this grief tosser. He won't be far.
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Elderman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
He's learning. But he is taking care of the people first. I did kill one person.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs and tend to the remaining wounded. Until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Oh, no. It doesn't end like this. It's time to kill.
A bold attack. And in broad daylight. The hatred that eats at that man must be ravenous.
What news, Hunwald?
We've learned that Herivrith rode for the fort at Anicastre, following the massacre.
I have assembled a fyrd there. Quite a large one, in fact. They eagerly await your orders, Eivor.
You mean your orders, Elderman?
Ah, yes, that's right. My orders. Which are what, exactly?
Who can say? Ride with me to your camp and we'll find out together.
Herivrith was a friend of my father's and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
It's not a story for now.
This will send waves of disgust through all the parishes of Mercia. Herivrith is a new and ugly stain on the bishopric.
Your Christ was an interesting man, if a little soft. But stranger still, I've met so few Christians like him.
Today has been a boon, Eivor. In spite of everything, I now know my father's spirit still burns within me. It's thanks to you I know this. When songs are sung of the day Lincolnshire was saved, your name will ripple through every stanza.
Don't be hasty, Hunwald. One verse of our song remains unsung. The din of battle beckons.
You pagans and your appetite for battle. I certainly don't share it. I worry what diabolical feast the bishop has in store.
Don't let that poxy bishop worry you. With Eivor beside us, he'll be victuals before long. How has Atcher taken all this? She and Herivrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. The poor lady.
We spoke briefly. Her spirits were low, but her work carried on. I think she'll be fine.
Manipulated by a man who should be God's gladdener.
Alright, what do we got?
Here's the camp, do you see? The fyrd will soon be ready for action.
Our warsmith has arrived. The fyrds are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this fight with the men you see assembled here?
If they fight with the bravery of double their number, we may.
And is there room in your Valhalla for a ferocious swan?
Of course. Let fly your glorious banner.
Are we ready then?
We attack
Let's
now.
Let's do this.
Ready the fyrd.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
Here's the camp, do you see?
Huh. You don't survive me, priest. No one ever does.
To me, holy warriors of Lincolnshire!
The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along. The Raven!
there. Move out of the way. Go further in, man! Get the drawbridge down. I have a feeling I did that. This is a bit fucked up.
Gods! Herophrith has got mad!
Don't now!
You! Point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scapless coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment.
Thank you.
the hell? Now your boss is gonna die.
I died the day I hid behind these robes, this cross. To bring the light of my order to a wider view, I did baste myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Herifrith. We wallow in our failures, like happy pigs in a sty of shit. You should have learned to enjoy it.
The liar. Tatafrit. Now it's time to steal. Oh, there was another entrance. He had an escape rope.
Eivor, is he?
Yes, he's
dead. Is the bishop dead?
He bled too little and talked too much. Now he's gone.
I won't miss him, but Atcha will need some time to grieve.
Lincolnshire is yours to lead, Elderman. The hardest fight begins now.
The din of battle still rings in my ears. I think I now know what it means to be a leader.
Good.
I would ask a favor if I could.
What?
Name it.
As Elderman, my life may be a dangerous one. For a time, anyway. Would you allow my Swanborough to take refuge in your settlement? At least until I feel all danger has passed.
Sure.
We'd be happy to
but
have
that you. Usually ends up bad for us.
Thank you, my sturdy Norse berserker. The mead halls of my shire will be lonely without you stomping about.
Our people are bonded now. We must look out for one another.
Blast it. I am a horror with goodbyes.
It'll do for now.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Ramley. Best tell her the good news.
Alright, so I'm gonna make my way back to Raventhorpe, and then I'm gonna see if I have a mission from the Hidden Ones. Oh, I could just go after them. Oh, and he's close. He's in Gratibretshire? Oh, he is so dead. So I'm gonna talk to Ramby, get this done, then I'm gonna go kill that guy.
Hi, Eivor.
Hey, kids. That's my dog.
Lincolnshire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news. And who is our ally there?
The boy Hunwald is the new Elderman of Lincolnshire, and he has sworn allegiance to us.
The Loud One, an Elderman? Well, should he ever wish to call for aid, he need only shout.
So we now have Lincolnshire. I'm gonna read this letter. Twilight targets.
Looks like I have a new letter.
Acha's letter. Dear Eivor, the wolf-kissed of Raventhorpe, I must confess further to the great sin and guilt I feel for having betrayed Hunwald and Swanborough. The Eldercy is stable for now, however my heart is not. I regret my actions, however subtle, they enabled Hereford to spill the blood of good yellow bellies upon the titles of our lord. I have so much love for you and respect. What you have endured unfairly, all of my prayers are directed at the light that shines through you and those you protect. Life is impossible, and I will turn my eyes up to him. Acha in faith. Alright, so now we're going to go kill this magistrate of the order. Then I'll call it a day there. Nope. So I'll see you guys when I start stalking him. Alright guys, here we are at the Lyre, and that is the second magistrate we have killed.
You won. I concede defeat. When Scops mention me, they will sing of my conquests.
Cowards do not get sagas.
I am no coward. In a long lost battle for Wessex, I was the victor. The Scot could speak of that time. Focus on my lost honor.
No. I'll leave your reputation as it is, here in the blood-blackened mud.
There we go. And that is our second magistrate murdered. So I'm going to pick this up in the next episode. Next episode, we will be going after... Oh, what's the place called? I can't say the name, but we'll be going after Jorvik, because there's supposedly 3 high-level members of the Order there, and that will give me the vice. So we will pick this up in the next episode. We're 2 out of 6. Wait, 2 out of 6? I guess 1 comes with the story. We are really cutting into the Order. I only have 2 more zealots to kill. No, 3 more zealots to kill. 3 more people for the vice. The rake is hidden. Folke is in the wind. I keep forgetting his name, but the King of Wessex. We'll kill him too. But yeah, in the next episode, remember, if you like the video, comment, like, and subscribe. It does help the channel. I mean, the numbers appreciate it. Prime thanks you. And I will pick this up in the next episode. So, yeah. We'll see you next time. Bye.